Hi, my name's Nina, and I love sketchbooks. Now, this is technically not a sketchbook, but it is a travel journal that I took with me on a trip a few years ago, which actually has a lot of drawings and journal entry pages that I wanted to show. There's actually two journals that go together for this trip because it was a month long, and this is part one, starting in Canada. It says here on the front, Toronto, New York, Chicago, and train across America. Part one of this epic journey that we took across North America. Hello, Canada. Here's a tiny little flag that I stuck in the book. It's quite a nice beginning to the journal. Places you write there. Yeah, this is just stuck in with some tape. I always travel with masking tape so that I can stick stuff in. As you'll see, I stick quite a lot in. So yeah, this is 2018, it says here. These are some little cutouts from a leaflet from an exhibition we went to. I really like these little line drawings, and I thought they'd go quite well with my writing as well. Wednesday, the 28th of March, 2018. This is from the very beginning of the trip, when we're waiting to depart and leave London. Here's a little piece about flying on planes. Here we've got this girl character in the middle, an annotated drawing of the various things you encounter when flying. Swollen legs that feel like sausages. Someone near me is A, snoring, B, crying, or C, has a cold. Envying the people with window seats that don't even care about the views. Severe ear poppage, static hair, dry skin, etc. So yeah, a little self-portrait there. Touchdown in Toronto. This is a photograph of Howardina Pintel. She's going to come up later on in the journal because we visited a show of her work. So yeah, this is just diary entry stuff. We went to an ice hockey game the first night we arrived. The next day we went to AGO, the Art Gallery of Ontario, which was amazing. My favourite part of the gallery was the room full of mountain paintings and the work of the Group of Seven, that's it, the Canadian landscape painters. I took some photos of some of the work and I did a mini version of it here in coloured pencil. It's quite a nice visual signifier of that exhibition when I'm flicking through my journal, and I've matched the date colour to the sky. Some more writing, other little bits that are stuck in. Here's a bus ticket, which I really love the sort of old-fashioned feeling of it, this kind of newsprinty thin paper. There's something I really love about the tactile nature and kind of old-fashioned these days nature of a bus ticket. So yeah, stuck that in. Some more writing. As you can see, something I like to do in my journals is mix up how I write the days and even how I write the entry for that day. I try and write it either in a different coloured pen or a different thickness pen. Here it's sort of cursive and joined up. Here it's joined up but not as cursive. Sometimes it's in uppercase. But either way, I try to differentiate the days. It just makes it easier for me to flick back through in the future. It means I can clearly see what was what day. It breaks up the time quite nicely, visually and in terms of content. Little Canadian maple leaf motif. Easter Sunday. Yeah, so we were there over Easter. Saw some amazing parades, so we were there for a few days until we flew to Michigan for a transfer, that is, en route to upstate New York. And this is an entry here on the left from some time spent at the airport. We had some time to kill. Here's a sugar packet that I cut out and stuck in. Went to a diner in the airport, just wrote about that, drinking lots of root beer. So we flew from Toronto via Michigan to a wonderful little town in upstate New York called Livingston Manor. Here's lots of writing about our few days that we spent there. So it's not very visual, just lots of details about what we did, the trip, the kind of surrounding area and descriptions of it, more written than drawn, except for here, which is a biro drawing of a lovely wooden house with a porch, which was opposite a farm shop that we were sat in, had coffee one morning. And this was just a spontaneous drawing. It was raining outside. We weren't in any rush. It's so nice to do. I love doing this when I travel. Just sit and have a coffee and watch the world go by, whether I'm drawing people or buildings or the interior or what I'm eating. I just think it's such a nice way to slow down for a sec and to really observe your surroundings and take a little bit of it and record it. And again, it breaks up the composition quite nicely in that there's a lot of text you can see throughout. My journals are mostly text-based, but I really do try to make an effort to get some visual interest in there as well, whether that's through changing the type, like I said, or these little vignettes, stuck in things as well. I think anything can go in a travel journal. Here I've tried to break up more text because there's a lot of writing, so I've just popped in this little pine cone, which is drawn with a brush pen with some pencil detail over the top, just to stand out, just to make the page a bit more visually interesting because the writing's quite scruffy here, so it makes it a bit more appealing. Here's another stuck-in ticket. This time it's my boarding pass. The next leg of the trip, we flew from upstate New York to Philadelphia. We changed at Philadelphia, we flew to Chicago after that. Spent a few days in Chicago, drinking more root beer here. I think I had it almost every day of the trip, I'm obsessed with it. We don't really get it over here in England, so yeah, whenever I get the chance to have it abroad, I'm straight on it. Friday the 5th of April, that's the date. We went to the Art Institute of Chicago. And I've written here about the American folk art section and the early American art and architecture design. Taken a little quote here from the show and yeah, done this little frame around it, which I don't think it's coincidental. I think I intentionally tied it in with this line going across the whole book, which is on every page, this sort of red line. I really like this paper as well. If you can see, it's quite faint, but it's this sort of honeycomb pattern on cream paper. So I love off-white paper. It's always so nice and non-pressured to work on. But also what's nice about it is this faint graphic pattern behind, very, very pale grey. And it gives quite a nice grid almost to write on. Doesn't make my writing completely straight. I don't think I can ever do anything in a straight line. But it's a really nice backdrop that stops it from feeling too plain. This is the day that we went to the Howardina Pindell exhibition. Yeah, it was a sort of a retrospective show about this artist's work called 1979, and it was just as much about memorabilia and that sort of culture of the time and what was happening in the world at the time as it was about her politically themed work. Amazing exhibition, full of a lot of interesting info and artifacts from that time. It was a really engaging show. There was an arcade there, free t-shirts and games, lots of interactive elements. It was amazing. Before we went to the show, we went to this coffee shop called La Colombe. And here, I think that's the logo of the coffee shop, which I tried to hand render. Another nice thing to sit and do in coffee shops is just copying type, whether that's menus, business cards, logos, whatever. It breaks up the page quite nicely. It jumps out, it's in another color. And it's just a way to practice a different kind of typeface that I wouldn't usually use. So trying to study the letters and adding these little serifs and documenting that. Had a lot of good coffee in Chicago. This is kind of a scrapbooky style page, using the old trusty masking tape again, and cutting out little sections from pamphlets, leaflets, tickets, business cards. There seemed to be a lot of free stickers places in the States when we were traveling around. So I gathered them all up and it's a nice record to keep in the book. Here's an outtake of a photo booth photo we had taken where I wasn't ready for the camera. You can see I'm fiddling with my hair, so rather than chuck it in the bin, I thought I'd stick it in here. And yeah, some more diary entries. We've got Monday, Sunday, talking about where we ate, what we ate, where we stayed. And then this was the next part of the trip. From Chicago, we boarded the Amtrak Empire Builder train. And this is a 2-day, one night journey from Chicago all the way to Portland. And this took us through a bunch of states, places we'd never been before and probably wouldn't get to see otherwise. We don't drive, so taking the train across the country was an amazing way to see these kinds of places and landscapes, and a great alternative to flying as well. We were trying to find another way of doing it. A lot of sitting and looking out the window for 2 days. So naturally, I wanted to find stuff to do in that time that was fun, but also relaxing, so nothing too pressured. And I wanted to create these tiny little snapshots of the landscape for each state that we crossed. I wanted to try and draw a tiny scene that, to me, summarized that kind of place. So I took lots of photos all the time, like every 5 seconds. My camera was snapping, trying to capture views out the window. Some of these drawings are based on actual literal scenes. Some of them are kind of made up in my head where I've combined parts of different scenes we saw. So maybe taking that mountain range but adding in some other trees I saw that I liked. So I put them in the foreground. Got Wisconsin, Minnesota, North Dakota, Montana. little visual descriptions, kind of trying to summarise the landscape at that time and what we saw, what we could see from the train. The sun is bright and hot through our cabin window. There's brilliant white snow all around and dark snow-streaked mountains in the distance. Bare trees, frozen ponds and rivers, a vintage car scrapyard. Yeah, I really, really like this spread. I think it's my favourite spread of the book. Just because of the amount of colour that's in it and the feeling you get, I mean, it brings back really strong memories of the trip and what it felt like, what it looked like, just these colour palettes going through these different places in the middle of winter. And just never done travel like this before. I'd never taken a train journey that long, let alone in another country. So it really was an amazing way to travel. Here's my ticket from the Amtrak. And I'm describing here the people that we met, strangers on a train. We've eaten with a couple from Wisconsin who have 9 children, 2 brothers from Pittsburgh who were travelling west for the first time, and a chap from San Francisco who lives by the Golden Gate Bridge. Fun little descriptions of people on the train. Ending the book with some stickers from the places we stayed. That was back in upstate New York. Some more bits and bobs stuck in. That is the end of part one of that trip. Make sure you check out part two, continued travels in America and Canada.